In the last video, we saw the sarcomere, which is made up of myosin and actin, overlap each other more or less in order to contract and relax. Now, in one myofibril, which is one of these little rods or cylinders here, the entire red cylinder you see is the muscle fiber, which is the cell. Inside the muscle fiber, we have myofibrils. Well, in these myofibrils, there's where your actin and myosin are. Those are your sarcomeres. So you can see in one cell, in one muscle fiber, there's going to be thousands and thousands of little sarcomeres in these myofibrils. So the question is, how do we get them to contract? How do we get them to slide and overlap like we saw on the previous video? We know that troponin and tropomyosin are blocking myosin heads from binding to actin. So we need to go through the whole story. So first off, muscle fibers cannot contract unless they are stimulated by a neuron. And here we see the end of a neuron, which is a nerve cell. We call that the axon terminal, the end of a neuron. So here we have nerve cell, neuron, contacting right there, contacting the muscle fiber. So we have contact between neuron and muscle fiber, so we call that the junction. Right? We call this junction the neuromuscular junction, where nerve meets muscle. So think of the neuron like a wire. And the wire will go to, let's say, a light bulb to turn it on. Well, this wire tells the muscle fiber to contract when it sends it its electrical energy to stimulate it. So let's go through the steps. An action potential, which we see here as a lightning bolt right there, right, is just a rush of electricity that rushes down to the end of the axon, which we call the axon terminal. So let's enlarge that section. Here we see the axon terminal. There we see the muscle fiber. So here's your neuromuscular junction right there. So when this voltage, which you see as a lightning bolt here, reaches the axon terminal, it says calcium rushes into the cell, and calcium causes exocytosis of acetylcholine, which is abbreviated to ACH. Well, you don't see calcium rushing in here, but it does. Calcium rushes into the cell, and we see all these vesicles with these little chemicals inside of it. Those chemicals are neurotransmitters. Neurotransmitters help transmit information from the neuron to the next cell. In this case, it happens to be a muscle fiber. So when that calcium rushes in, we have exocytosis, and all this neurotransmitter, all these neurotransmitters are released from the neuron. Now, if we're talking about a neuromuscular junction like we are here, the neurotransmitter specifically is called acetylcholine, or ACH. So all these little chemicals that just got released into this gap, those are acetylcholine neurotransmitters. That little space between neuron and muscle fiber is called the synaptic cleft. A cleft is a gap. And where the two cells communicate, like right here, is a synapse. So that term makes sense, a synaptic cleft. So let's enlarge this even more in this picture right here, right? And we see those acetylcholines released into the synaptic cleft. And they'll bind right there, right, and right there to a receptor in the sarcolemma or in the plasma membrane of the muscle fiber. So when these little acetylcholines bind to a receptor on the muscle fiber, right there, binds to receptors, well then sodium ions rush into the cell. So we can see here there's a little channel that causes sodium, Na, should be Na plus, looks like Na negative there, right? Sodium rushes in. And what happens there is that we change from negative to positive on the inside of the cell. So this part of the sarcolemma, which is the plasma membrane of the muscle fiber, we call that the motor end plate, because that's the motor part, the muscle cell part of the neuromuscular junction. So something to remember, here's a cell, let's say, and we've learned in the past that there's more potassium ions on the inside, more sodium ions on the outside, right? Both of these ions are cations. They're positively charged. But the sodium-potassium pump says three leave from two, for two that enter. So since more positives are leaving, the outside of the membrane is positive. The inside of the membrane is negative. That's the cell at rest, like right here. So when this action potential reaches the muscle fiber and acetylcholine flies across the synaptic cleft, attaches to a receptor, and then sodium rushes in, well, now that positives are rushing in, now the inside, which was negative, becomes more positive. That's what it's saying here. So when all of this happens at this neuromuscular junction, well, that negative interior changes to positive because of the sodium, which is a positive charge, rushing into the cell. Yeah, that's a lot to take in. So you might need to watch that a few times. But just real quickly, let's recap on this picture. The action potential travels down the neuron to the axon terminal. When it does so, calcium rushes in. When calcium rushes in, that causes these vesicles full of acetylcholine to release through exocytosis the acetylcholine into the synaptic cleft. Acetylcholine binds to the receptors on the motor end plate. Remember, the motor end plate is the part of the sarcolemma. Sarcolemma is the plasma membrane of the muscle fiber, the part of the sarcolemma that's part of this neuromuscular junction. So here it's just a sarcolemma of the muscle fiber. But here, where we have this synapse, we call that the motor end plate, like you can see here. So acetylcholine binds to these receptors in the motor end plate. That causes sodium to rush in. Actually, potassium rushes out as well, like you can see here, which changes the interior to positive. And that change in voltage causes this rush of electrical energy on this motor end plate. We call that end plate potential. Now, if that end plate potential is strong enough to get out of the motor end plate right here where it's just normal sarcolemma, well, then that's an action potential. And the action potential, just like we had here, action potential, will start traveling along the plasma membrane of the muscle fiber. Of course, the plasma membrane of the muscle fiber is called the sarcolemma. Now, if an action potential does occur, it's all or nothing. That means it won't lose strength across the whole muscle fiber.